Okay, so what I've done is I've just simply logged into Glow and I've come to my Launchpad. I'm now going to click on Google Drive, and that's going to sign me in the background to my re.glow.scot account. Once I'm in there, I go to the nine dot waffle and I scroll down until I see the sign for Jamboard and I simply click on it. The Jamboards will load up. If it's the first time you've used it, there'll be nothing here. If it's not the first time you've used it, you'll see that what you have already. Down here on the bottom right-hand side, you have this lovely great big plus button, which you're just going to hit that plus button. And what that will do is that will open up for me a blank Jamboard. Now, one of the nice things is it's within your Google Meet. If you are hosting a Google Meet for something, you can actually set up a Jamboard within the Google Meet. Now, if it's not in Glow yet, it's coming soon. So this is me. This is what a Jamboard looks like. So I've got various functions that I can access on my Jamboard. I'm just going to pop this out the way. And with these functions, I have the pen tool. Now you see there's a little arrow next to the pen tool. If I click on the arrow, that allows me to choose different types of pens, and you'll see when I hover over it, it tells me the types of pens, and there's even a brush as well, and I can choose the color. So once I've selected the pen, I'm just doing this with my mouse just now, but obviously if you've got a touch screen device like a Chromebook, you're going to be able to write directly onto that touch screen. Okay, so that's the pen tool. Then we have the eraser tool, which just as it says, you can just use it to rub out. So you can just rub out where you've been. If you've got lots of stuff on the screen that you've changed your mind about, you're quicker using the clear frame button, because that just takes everything off of the full frame at that point. The next one is obviously your select tool, so don't forget to go back to your select tool if you want to start moving things around. And then we have probably the most used tool, which is the sticky note tool. So you click on the sticky note, it pops up, and you have the options to have different colours simply by clicking on them. And you can have no colour as well, depending on whether or not you've got a coloured background. Then you simply type to write on them. And then you say save. Now, this will stay up so that you can do that until you hit cancel. One of the things that you can do, let me just pause. So with this note, one of the things that you can do, you see that I'm in the select tool and I'm moving it around now. And you have the three dots here, and it's really handy. You can duplicate a note. So if there's something that you need to have lots of, so I'm thinking in terms of you might have put a pile of stickies on there that have perhaps faces around what you want the children, you know, about feelings. You might have a selection of feelings on there. You can quickly just, if you've got a smiley face on there, duplicate that sticky note, and then what that would mean is that the kids can just pick it up and move it to wherever they want once you've duplicated it. So that's your sticky note. You can also go back in and edit a note once you've done it, so you can change the colours and you can change the text by going into that edit button. And one of the other things that you can do, you'll see that they automatically order themselves by when the kids put them in. So if you don't want that order, you click on those three dots and you simply change the order. So you send them backwards or to the back, just as you would in a normal kind of Word type document. And that means that this one's now on the top. So it's quite handy to be able to reorder them should you need them. Okay, the next tool is the image tool. And one of the great things you can do with the image tool is you can upload any images that you have on your drive. So I'm thinking if you perhaps had, thinking if you were reading a novel and you had a character, you could upload the character picture onto the Jamboard and ask the kids to put information around that. You know, I keep going back to, you know, I think, I see, I wonder type activities. You could have different characters on there and you can use different boards. So you can upload it, you simply browse the file that you want. So I'm just going to go into my pictures just now. So I know I've got a nice picture here. Where we go? Let's take that one. And I just simply drag it on and it will upload it. And the good thing with this is I can make it bigger or smaller as I need. And I can move that around. Okay, and then the children can just add their comments on and round about that. With the camera tool, you also have the option, you can take a picture. So if you go to camera, I can't show you this just now because I'm obviously in the Teams meeting, but if you click on camera, it would come up with your normal camera and you can take a picture of yourself. So, you know, maybe if you're dressed as a character for something or there's a particular funny face you want to make, whatever, you can take a picture of that. By clicking on Google Images, you can also go straight into Google Images and do a Google search, making sure that obviously you check for the copyright. And then any images that you've saved in your Google Drive, so if, for example, you've taken pictures of your class and you want to put particular class members up there, you can click on Google Drive and then you can find all of your photographs in that way. And then it just imports it onto the frame just like that. Okay. Other tools that are helpful, you have your shape tool. Again, by clicking on that little side arrow, you can see there's a variety of shapes that you can add in. You can add in arrows and all sorts of different things. You simply click on it and then you can draw that shape out to the size that you want it to be. Okay. Then, of course, we have the text box. Similar to the sticky, you can add a text box. So you simply click in the space and you can type in the text box. And then from there, again, you have these three dots. So you can duplicate it. You can order it in the same way as all the other objects on the page. And also that's, I should have mentioned earlier, that's where you delete everything to. So you've got all of these options in there with the text box. In your text box, again, if I click and I go back to edit, as you would normally have, you have your editing tools. So I can change my color of my text and I can change, we'll make it display. There's a limited what you can change it to, but you get the idea. If you simply click and drag, you can actually make it bigger anyway. So it's worth having a play about with it to see, all right, what have I got there? What do I want to do with it? Okay. You've also got the option to rotate. You'll notice that that little arrow came up when I was on the text box, and you can rotate, and you'll notice that that exists on all of the images, all of the objects that are within the frame. Gosh, it's making me go all wonky now. So there you go. So you've got all of these options here. And again, if you don't want to, simply click delete and it disappears. The last tool down here is the laser pen. I find the laser pen is really handy if you're presenting something in your class and you simply want to highlight something. So you do this and then it just disappears. So it's like shining a laser pointer on the screen. So it's nice and handy. Okay, so other things then that we've got, you've got the option up here to zoom in and zoom out. Remember, what you're seeing on screen isn't the full, could be the full page, but it might not be depending on your screen size. So if you click on it, you see I'm only actually seeing 40%. And if I go to 100%, you actually get an idea of how big this page is as I scroll up and down and how big I've made my images. So it's worth having a wee check of that. If you think that you are going to be exporting this or downloading this for a particular reason, I think that's worth noting. As I mentioned earlier, you've got the clear frame option. If you hit clear frame, everything on the frame disappears, and you need to train your learners not to do that. Because one of the things about a Jamboard is everybody comes in with the same editing rights, so just train them not to do that. If you want another frame, another page, you simply click on the down arrow and that lets you bring up another frame. And what you'll find is the first few times you use it with learners, they click and they click and they click and you end up with hundreds of pages and you're like, I don't want all these pages. So you simply click here and then that allows you to hover over each one and you can simply delete it. Or if you particularly like a frame, you've got that option there, as you can see, to duplicate it. So you can have several frames with the same background. And then you just click on the arrow to pop that back up. Now, one of the best features, I think, is the set the background. So you have, you know, you can change the background to lots of different preset things. And you've got this option to bring in an image. Now, if you remember, when I brought in that image, I was able to pick it up and move it anywhere I wanted. If you want to have an image on the background that the kids can't move, maybe thinking about that characterization that we mentioned earlier, then what you want to think about is bringing that in to the background. So again, I'm just going to browse for it. I'm going to grab my picture file. That's me having a cup of coffee. That'll do. And what that does is it inserts it into the background, and that means that everything else is movable, but it is not. So that's really handy if you're bringing in a particular thing that you don't want them to move. Because as I say, the kids can move everything, so just be wary of that. Okay? Right, so once you're happy with everything, you've got all that stuff that you want, over here you have the three dots. So what you can do is you can download it. So if you've created, I keep using the characterization, but say you've done your novel, you've got I Think, I See, I Wonder, you've got that all on a frame or a couple of frames, and you want that as evidence because you want to be able to show that evidence to someone else, then you simply download it as a PDF. The other thing that you can do is you can save the frame as an image, which means you're saving it as a picture image. So it's like a JPEG that you're keeping it as. So again, think about why I might want to keep it, and you can choose which of the tools you want to use there. And then we have this really helpful one, which is make a copy. So you can imagine if you're working with a group and you've got, you know, you've got four groups in your class or five groups in your class for that reading thing, make a copy for each group. Great tip, when you title it, I should have shown you that at the beginning, click on Untitled Jam, number it one, Character Thoughts. Okay, and then number the next one two, and then it'll be much easier for you to find it, and you'll remember which group had it or whatever your group names are. But also numbers means they come in the order that you want, so it's nice and easy for you to find. And that means you just make the same board once, make a copy, and then you distribute it out to the learners. Now you can distribute to the learners using the share button here. And what that does is it gives you the link. Now at the moment it's restricted to share with Renfrewshire Council only, which is great if you're only using it in your class, but you have got that set to a viewer. You need to make sure that you let them be an editor if you want them to write on the board. Otherwise they'll be like, Miss, sir, I can't open it. And you're like, no, you're right, you can't. So that gives you the Renfrewshire Council, or if you're sending something home for them to work on at home, you can do anyone with the link that saves any restrictions. But as always, I would caveat that with think about when you're sending it with anyone with the link. And when you're happy, just click done. You can then share that in your Google Classroom. You can share it on a class blog, any number of ways you can share that, because it's literally just a URL for you. Okay, one last thing that I'm going to show you is just very quickly, I'm going to share my screen on a different screen and show you one of the great wee features that you can do. Can you see my Canva page now? Yeah. Okay, so on this screen, what you have is if you've got a Canva account, which is free for teachers, they have loads and loads of templates. And they, if you go to templates, you can actually search for Jamboard. Just let that open up. So if you type in the search Jamboard backgrounds, it'll come up with a Jamboard background, and there's loads of templates. You don't even need to make these up. You can just click on any one that you like. Let's say that this is a SWOT analysis one I've picked. So you just simply click on it and you hit customize. It'll open up within your Canva account. And once you've changed it and added in the bits that you want, which I'm not going to do just now because we'll be here all night, then I click on share. And then if I scroll down, I have the option to download it, and I can download it as a picture. But one of the nice things I love about Canva is if you pick a particular object within Canva, you can do things like animate it. So you're turning it into a GIF. So what you can actually do is you can download it as a GIF and import that into your Google background as a GIF, which I will just show you now. So if I go on to a new frame, so best blue Peter, you know, here's one that I prepared earlier. So let me just browse for the file that has the GIF on it in my downloads, and then you'll see it'll come in as a little GIF. Apologies, you can never find these things quickly when you're looking for it. So this was just a wee getting to know you activity that I thought might be helpful, especially with a new class or if you're in covering. And you can see how that popped up there and it animated as it came in, and it will keep animating, which is quite nice for a little bit of interest for the learners. Okay, so I'm going to stop there.